Hello, everyone. I feel like I've been getting a few hints and questions of making more content related to Batman the Animated Series, and I will oblige, basically. I've made a few SWAT members, and I've got the Red Hood figure, and I made a Scarecrow with the old design. I've seen a lot of people ask for an old design Scarecrow, but they should have just included that to begin with in the collection or the head sculpt with the Scarecrow that released. I feel like it was quite okay to make. So I also made these three custom like SWAT officers. Tried to have them as generic looking as possible. I feel like I'm getting a little bit better at that, and I had some I bought an accessory lot, basically custom fodder of a guy who collected for over his lifetime. So I bought a box that was like almost 10 kilos of custom figures. Custom accessories, and yeah, just a ton of things: knives, grenades, walkie-talkies, radios, glasses, hats, shoes, body parts, armor plates, police badges, everything you can imagine. 10 pairs of handcuffs, flashlights, everything you can imagine. So I could use all of these things for, like, I have the same, like, flashbang grenade. I feel like it's a grenade, maybe just a regular grenade. And also, the radios are the same. And the one that doesn't have a radio, this one, he's supposed to have this walkie-talkie in his hands because he's basically like the leader. So that's why I have that. And I have them in three poses. So these are. What body did I use for this? I feel like this is the Batman from Gods and Monsters, which I just pick up for like $10 a piece, and then I destroy them basically. I use what I want to use, and then I add sculpt to it, like the boots and the belt, the armor, the helmet basically. The glasses are still original, and then the like strap piece I made myself. It's just nice to do, and now I have a SWAT team that I can put in for the Mask of the Phantasm scene where they're chasing him. And then Bullock says, "You jerk, get a light up there." It's just great to have these figures finally. I feel like it would be easy to do something, but I could understand DC Direct, especially now with the situation we're having with DC Direct, that they're probably not gonna make any more figures except for the last few Adventures Continue figures, which are starting to release right now in USA. I've seen a few on eBay already for like $40. So going on to the Red Hood, I purchased a Red Hood because I saw it on a French seller had it for sale. I asked him just what he wanted because I felt like he was going to ask 70 or 80 euros. He charged me 61 euros shipped, which is like $66 shipped. Now that's quite a lot, but I didn't want to risk it because I have everything of this except for the Harley Quinn's expression pack. And the Montoya figure. I don't really care for those. I'll probably find those down the line. I'm not too worried about that. But the new figures I have on pre-order at a few different stores in the Netherlands, in Belgium, in the USA, so Big Bad Toy Store as well, just to secure the figures for the collection. Yeah, and that's basically where that comes from. So I'm keeping it in a package until I know I can get my hand on another one. Because I don't know if this is a figure that I need in my collection for 60 euros, because I can purchase a Mezco for that basically. It does look fantastic, I do have to say. It's pretty nice looking, and I love that there's an extra hat piece in there. It's just really cool looking. I like the cell shading on this. And I like the old pants and the cell shading. I like the shadows on the painted on the boots as well. This would have been a perfect body for like police officers, but it's a really expensive body. And I also made this Scarecrow. So this is just the new Batman Adventures Riddler, and I customized him into this. I know the bag is supposed to end in his throat basically, so it's not a mask that he wears over this, but this was easier means of design for the new Batman Adventures Riddler. And yeah, the sculpting is a little bit, it was a little bit fast. This was a fast project, but I'm happy with it for now. I can always improve it later down the line, so I can smoothen out the edges and do a better paint job maybe. But when you see this, you know it's the Scarecrow, you know it's the older design, it's not the new one. He's a little bit skinnier than the other design. I do have the other design as well, but he's in a box right now. So this is just a few things that I've been working on slash been dealing with. But yeah, it's a nice time to be alive. I have this entire full bin. I'll give you a little glimpse of that with all of my custom figures in there. There's 100 figures, custom, well, bases basically, which I will be working on for a few figures. So thank you so much for watching. Let's talk about Batman the Animated Series.